Hello everyone, I'm Rohit. I, on behalf of Sierra Aurobindo Society, would like to welcome all the teachers to one of the most successful and innovative idea sharing platform of India, ZIIEI, that is Zero Investment Innovation for Education Initiative. Here we will be discussing about new and innovative techniques for the different lessons from our chapters, and in short, we will learn how to make the whole process of learning fun and interesting for the kids. Today, the chapter that I will be covering is from Class 3. Subject is Environmental Studies. Name of the board is NCERT. And the name of the chapter is the Plant Failure. The main innovation that I will be using here for covering this lesson is known as Cheat Game. That is C-H-I-T, Cheat Game. The main innovation behind using this idea is to make the students revise the concepts that have already been taught in their class through a playful method so that they get more interested towards the topic and can easily retain their things for a longer period of time. Some of the important concepts that we'll be revising on are features of leaves, features of plants, and different diversity of plants. The duration for implementing this idea will be 40 minutes. Before implementing this idea, we need to make some pre-arrangements. So the pre-arrangements are an empty bowl and few slits of paper, blank slits of paper. First of all, before implementing the activity, we enter the class and we tell the students that students, today we'll be revising the concepts that we have learned in the previous lesson with the help of a game which will be known as cheat game. In this, we give the instructions to the students. In this, I will be calling out one student. You will be calling out one student one by one. The student will be coming to pick a cheat from the bowl, and he or she will have to read out loud whatever word is written on it, and then he or she will be asked questions based on the word that is written on that, and then he will be given certain time frame for answering those questions, and if he or she cannot answer the questions, then they can either take the help from the fellow classmates, or at the end, we ourselves will provide help to them. Before doing the activity, we initiate a discussion for giving them for revising the concepts. We take all the students outside. We divide the whole class into small groups, certain groups, and we tell them to go around the playground and look out for different kinds of plants and leaves, and then note down few observations about that, like their different colors, patterns, and shapes, and so on. We give them certain time for that, say 10 minutes. Once they assemble together, we ask each group what they've observed and what are their observations about that leaf or plant. Suppose, say, group one might say that we have seen a plant. It's not very tall, it's medium size. It has flowers of yellow color and its leaves are green. Or say another group might say that the plant was fallen on the ground and it was of dark green color, and so on. They will continue. Once all the groups have given out their data, so have shared the information they have gathered, we appreciate all of them for doing the effort. Then we take them back to the classroom. Then we tell them that we will be doing an activity. We'll be playing that game, which is known as cheat game. Before doing the activity, we make our column on the blackboard. In the first column, it will be written name of the leaf or plant. In the next, it will be written features. And in the third column, it will write uses. In a sheet of paper, we will write the name of different leaves, plants, or flowers. And keep it on the bow. Same, we can write marigold or neem, basil, mint, etc. Depending upon from the chapter itself. Then we call out the students one by one. They will have to come up to the bowl filled with cheats. They will pick up one cheat. Then suppose they get marigold. Then he or she will have to say, first of all, different shapes. About the features of the plants, which will include its color, its shape, its pattern. Next, he or she will say the uses of that flower. And so on, we continue unless and until we complete with all the students. And while the students are doing so, we keep on writing the information on the blackboard so that the other students can get a view of the things which they have already discussed about, and they can also note down on their notebooks. This way we continue till the end. And when we start teaching the students in this way, we start getting a lot of learning outcomes. First of all, when the students will be coming up to the place and picking up a cheat and saying some words or saying some things on that, then it will help in developing their critical thinking and decision-making process. When they'll be speaking in front of the whole audience, whole people, it will help in developing their communication skill. When the whole students will be walking in groups, looking out for plants and noting down their different features about the plants or leaves, it will help in developing the teamwork. Apart from this, it will also create an environment of self-learning environment within the whole classroom. And when you start implementing these ideas in your own classroom, then apart from the benefits which I have mentioned, you will also get a lot of other benefits out of it. And for this video, that's all for this video. If you like this video and you want more of such videos from us, please do like, share and subscribe to our official channel, ZIIEI.